Jackson and Tory Brewster.
Hot. And today we're going to be showing you how to make a waffle. Like.
And the materials you need is vegetable oil, coloring,
and your bottles,
glass, and water. And an alcohol supply. So first you would do, fill the glass with vegetable oil.
Oh. How old do you do?
Halfway.
Because she did the introduction, and then you can do that.
Next, you will fill the rest of the flask with water.
No, I mean, like,
it's going to be great, you guys. And remember, when you're doing it, be around the parent. This is cautious.
Next, you will put food coloring.
Should I say
food coloring? Do not eat. Sorry.
One or two drops.
Maybe three.
Not on the side. Not on the side. All right, thank you. Next, you will break the alpha-sulfur crust into two pieces. Put one. Zoom in on it. And now you will see, mix it up a little bit. Put another piece. We gotta wait till the food coloring get in there. And now I will show you it in the dark. Please cut the lights. Cut the lights for us. My bad. And there is your homemade waffle.
This is pretty awesome.
This is awesome, dude.
The science between a homemade waffle and fruit is because two different scientific principles, Disney and polar, I don't know how to say this word, but if you measure the water and oil, you'll see that water is heavier than some amount of oil. Water particles are tightly packed, and a cup of water is heavier than a cup of oil. Oil molecules don't have a positive or negative charge, so that's why it doesn't attract to water. Instead of using it light, the alpha-sulfur is the power. The alpha-sulfur reacts to water by producing carbon dioxide gas levels. And you use color, food coloring, to give it a color. Thank you.